This is just for fun.
I'm playing X because I saw a screenshot that this song Middle possibly could be about X. So right here, it says Middle Child. XXXTentacion's birthday is January 23rd. X has two siblings, and an older one has a younger sibling, one meaning X. X was the middle child. Rest in peace. J. Cole also tweeted, he said tears writing. So the song is probably about X. He said just a theory. And I was like, all right, bet. That's tough. So shout out to J. Cole. I love J. Cole. Bought both 2014. And I also bought KOD. Cause that's after KOD, I just had to put respect on J. Cole's name. You can't not put respect on his name. Yeah, he's just the GOAT, bro. He's just the GOAT. And it's like, I just really respect him. So you gotta pay for these guys' albums, yo. Cause like streaming, it's a new beast that people are just not figuring out. And everyone's trying to dish out this whole don't buy physical copy stuff. Like, no, bro. I wanna support my artists. I just bought X's stuff too. You know, he's passed away. S&P is one of my favorite artists and, for me. I just miss the dude, man. For real. I miss the dude. But now it's 9 o'clock and he be doing all this tweet storm and ain't on our music. He blowing me.
This is how you call a flip. 10 keys from the car to brick. Bentley from his mama whip. KOD, he hard as shit. This is what you call a flip. 10 keys. Niggas been counting me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting so tired. I might take a sip, I might hit the bluff, but I'm liable to trip. I ain't popping no pill, but you do as you wish. I roll with some fiends, I love them to death. I got a few mil, but now some niggas slid in my lane. Everything grows, it's destined to change. I love you little niggas, I'm glad that you came. I hope that you scrape every dollar you came. I hope you know money won't erase the pain. I've been wanting something I can feel.
Yo, this whole song was immaculate, yo. I love the object of this song. I love the concept of it. It's amazing. I thought it was something that J. Cole does all the time, but it's different because it's like, who does this? No one talks about us like that. No one does this. And the thing is, I don't like autotune when it's so heavily used, but he used it in a manner that was finessey, bro. He used it in an appropriate manner. He did it. And then he's out here talking his boisterous about he's confident in himself. I love it. And he said, the real ones die and the fake ones are lit. Come on, bro. You know what that's about. He's saying X is the one that he's a real one, and the other ones out here are lit, but they're not real, you know? They're fake, bro. I just think that's crazy, and he used autotune amazingly. And for me, I think J. Cole is a better artist, but Kenny is a better rapper. That's just my opinion. I just love J. Cole. And I do appreciate and respect Kenny, but I really do think that Kenny is the better rapper, but J. Cole is the better artist. He's better sonically, in my opinion. So, and I think it's great that he said that two legends can't live at once. And it's like, why can't they, you know? Like he brought up a good point, like, why can't they? Why can't we love both Kenny and J. Cole? Kenny just got an actual Oscar nomination. Come on, bro. Like, we do this. Us black people do this, bro. Man, J. Cole is amazing, bro. And y'all need to buy Middle Child. We need to buy Middle Child. If y'all are not buying Middle Child and not getting this man his credit, like, he's out here being an artist for us, bro. Like, come on, we have to pay for this. This the concept of the song is amazing. Honestly, J. Cole is coming and it's in his bag, and I see great things with this man. Jay-Z's marketing plan for J. Cole. Wait, there were other impressive aspects of Jay-Z's marketing plan for J. Cole. When Jay-Z was putting together the first album for Roc Nation, he prominently featured J. Cole on a track called All Stars Is Born. when XXL magazine put Jay-Z as a cover in October 29th, the issue was also featured on story of J. Cole. Featured a story on J. Cole, not to mention a 24-page spread of Rockwear ads at the front of the book, and over 26 pages of editorial content focused on Jay-Z. Knowing Jay-Z, Jay-Z's tendencies, none of these were coincidence. That was like the smartest idea for marketing for Jay-Z, because it might seem a little vain and like, oh, I'm the bigger picture, but realize that he was that big at that time. If he was that, he was that big, and he could do stuff like that, and people would read all 24 pages of the ads, you know? They're in like all with the notes and stuff like that. Like, you'd be surprised. Like, I read a lot of lengthy articles on people that I love, like Jinx. I just read a huge interview on him. I still, like, he just has a lot of books that I want to read, that I saw him read. And I just thought it was like the coolest thing to see that. And I just thought it was smart for J. Cole, Jay-Z to do that for J. Cole. Because once they're looking for me, if I saw like someone like Joe Budden had like secret little intakes or little snippets of someone else that he wanted to bring on, I'm like, all right, bet, let me just read about this guy. Or who is this guy? Because I see him on a Jay-Z's editorial. I just thought that was really cool. A snippet of, so I just thought it was really cool and smart and a genius idea. Because if I see Joe Budden, like I said, if I see Joe Budden doing it for someone like Jinx, I'm going to know who Jinx is because I'm going to look him up after I'm done reading about Jay-Z. That's just how it is. That's smart marketing. I thought it was brilliant. Tell me what y'all think about, first of all, this right here, because I don't want this to seem gimmicky. I mean, I just kind of thought it'd be different to actually like share what I'm reading with y'all, and I just don't want this to seem gimmicky at all. If you guys don't want to see it, I mean, I won't do it. If you guys want to see it, I'll do it, but it's never to lure you guys in and like just hold y'all in. Like, I mean, it's just, I just kind of do it to be different. You know, I want to actually share knowledge and not just be like, oh, this song is good, this song is great, blah, blah, blah. And because you know people do that. That's not really my lane. I just really love reading about hip-hop, and I just love hip-hop music, you know? So, this seems gimmicky, like, it's not, but if you guys don't want to see this, you guys don't have to, just tell me you don't want to see it, and it'll be dead. I'll just read this on my, because I read this, I'm almost done with it. I read this on my own time. I'm actually almost done with this book. So thank you guys for watching. If you're new, thank you guys for watching. All right, y'all. Peace!